born before the wind. Also younger than the sun. Yeah, the bonnie boat was won as we sail into the mystic. Oh, I can now hear the sailors cry. Smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the mystic. And when that foghorn blows, I will be coming home. Yeah, when the foghorn.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. We're going to need more of a response than that today. It is a celebration. I've hung out with the Gaudios personally, and I know you could be a little bit louder than that. So let's try this again. Good evening, everyone. There we go. My name is Jermaine Pugh, for those who have not met yet. And Lauren and Nick, thank you for coming today to sharing this special occasion with them. Your presence here today celebrates the love that they found within one another, and also demonstrates your support of their decision to commit to a lifelong relationship together. They want to thank both of their parents for all your years of continuous support and love. Your dedication and your hard work has developed these two beautiful people you see standing before us today. And they want to thank you from the bottom of their hearts, because without you and you, they would not be here today. And they're also blessed to share this special day with all of you, their loving family, and incredible friends. Now, before we start today's festivities, I'd like to take a moment to please acknowledge the loved ones that unfortunately have passed away and can't be here with us today. But I know they're all shining down at this very moment and smiling down on us. Nick's father, Ralph, his grandfather, Anthony, and his grandmother, Carmela, and Lauren's grandmother, Viola, and grandfather, William. I know that their spirits and presence will be with us throughout this day, and may they bless this joyous day. And if they were here, I'm sure they would definitely be thrilled to see the two of you confessing your eternal love for one another. Okay, now I'll ask everyone to please stand. Lauren and Nick, can you please turn to acknowledge the crowd? As their family and friends of the bride and groom, you guys all offer a unique support system in the community for Lauren and Nick. And by being present today, you're all being called upon in your own special way to ensure they uphold these special vows they're about to take today. And one may ask, how can I ensure that I do this? By simply guiding them towards always loving each other, being there and offering your conditional love and commitment to them when they ask for your advice, always standing beside them and never in between them. And I ask that, yeah, exactly. And I ask that you offer your encouragement when encouragement is needed, and always be there with open hearts and open ears when they ask for your advice. These are the ways in which you can help strengthen this union and this marriage. So I ask if you guys are willing to dedicate a lifetime of support and commitment to making this marriage stronger and blessing the family that's going to be created today, that you answer in unison, we do.
We do.
Thank you. And now Charles would like to come up and share a reading with you. Charles?
Go Let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your soul.
Thank you, Charles. Now, the next part of our ceremony, we're doing a traditional knot tying ceremony. Jason, can you just grab our end? Okay, it'll be okay. All right, these two ends, while separated, represent Lauren and represent Nick as individuals, the life they've had in the past. Upon tying these two knots today, they will in fact be joining together as one. And when the knot is in its completion, it'll be strong, sturdy, and inseparable, like your love and your future.
Okay.
Ready?
Start in the middle. Turn to the crowd.
There you go.
All right, hang on.
Nick, you're a fireman.
Hang on, I got it. Let me get stuck. Hang on. Right, then it was.
It only matters how it ends up.
There we go. No, we got it. Hold that up there. All right, just give us one sec to clean it up.
Take your time. Can I get a picture of this, please?
Went a lot smoother last night.
No, we got it. I'm almost there. Hang on. Second. I think
that's tight.
Right?
I think that's pretty good.
It's a heart.
Oh, very nice.
We'll retie that one later.
Okay.
Should we give that back to Jason?
Jason gets that.
There you go, Jason.
Now, you may all be seated. I never sat him down before.
I know. That's funny.
Make it a word. All right. Lauren and Nick are taking an extremely brave step in a relationship today. They're making the ultimate commitment in marriage, a true confession of a couple's love together. They've committed themselves to one another's hearts, to going through all of life's incredible moments together, and to ensuring that each other's dreams come true, hand in hand. Now, let me ask, that's a lot to agree to, but spending time with these two over the last few years, there's good reason for it. I can honestly say that when I see the two of them together, they are more happy hanging out than I can say that I thought was humanly possible between two people. And over the last 9 years, 10 years knowing Lauren, I've gotten to know her personally. She's been even a better friend to my wife for even longer. And I can honestly say that the term friends would not do the bond between the three of us justice. Lauren's more than simply a roommate, a bridesmaid, or even a best friend. Lauren's the one that you can always count on. She's the one you can always go to for encouragement when you think there's doubt. You're more than just a friend to us. You're a sister.
Thank you.
You're family. Well, just when I thought Lauren couldn't get any better.
No.
She gives my wife a call a few years back and says that she's going on a date with this amazing guy from New York. She thinks he's a firefighter. He's tall, he's handsome. And his name is Nick Gaudio. And getting to know Nick over the last few years, as you all know him, his family, he's an extremely intelligent man. He's handsome and he's brave. He's a man we should all try to emulate. But the one thing I've noticed after spending a lot of time with him is that he truly loves Lauren. He understands her. And he gets everything about her. And take it from a personal friend, there could be a lot to get about Lauren at times. But the thing about Nick.
This isn't a roast here.
It's not a roast. But the thing about Nick is that he truly does. He understands her. He not only gets her, but he loves everything about her. And watching their love grow over the last 3 years, it's been truly inspirational to me. And since your first date, I know you guys have been soulmates and that you guys complete one another. And if I could take one thing away that I've learned from them, it's that when you find that special someone that makes every day of your life more enjoyable, it makes every day of your life that much more special, you hold on to them and you don't let them go. Now, Kelly would like to come up and do a reading.
Now you will feel no rain, for you each will be sheltered for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead, and through all the years, may happiness be your companion, and your days together be good and long upon the earth. Treat yourself and each other with respect, and remind yourself often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear fill your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between you, not only the part which seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun in your lives, remembering that even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is still there. And if each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and delight.
Now Lauren and Nick would like to share their vows with you. Nick, you'll be going first.
Alright, you ready? Alright, Lauren, we always joke around about how you were the self-proclaimed life enhancer and how much enhancing you've done to my life. You truly have, and I'm a better man for you. You truly have, and I'm a better man with you in my life. I love you with all my heart, and I make the following...
It's okay, breathe.
Maybe we should let Lauren go. Let me only collect myself. All right. Love you all my heart, and I make the following solemn promises to you in the presence of God and our family and friends. I vow to honor you, to respect you, and to love you unconditionally for all my days. I vow to support you in all our life endeavors, no matter how small or large. I vow to keep you safe, protect and shelter you from any harm. I vow to cherish the time we have and never take you for granted. I vow to keep an open mind, to be flexible, to always communicate and share my feelings with you. I vow to be a source of strength that you always rally to. I vow to always safely return home after every fire department call and not to try to wake you up on the late night ones. Above all else, I vow to dedicate my all to being the best husband and father. So, in the end, I'm glad I went first because I have a few suggestions for Lauren to add to her vows. One, you vow to let me go fishing at least once every 2 weeks during the peak fishing season. Two, you vow not to get angry with me when I finish the ice cream container since I'm apparently not lactose intolerant. And finally, you vow not to throw away my rim socks and underwear because every guy knows that those are the most comfortable ones. And that's it.
That is true. From the moment I met you, you have surprised me, captivated me, encouraged me, and challenged me in a way that no one has ever have. You have made me a better person, and I am truly blessed to be part of your life, which as of today becomes our life together. I can't wait for baby G to arrive when we become one happy family. I promise to be open, honest, kind, and patient with you, to be your partner in life and the best mother to our child, to love and support you, and to challenge you and maybe let you win at tennis once in a while. I know our love will never fade, that we will always find strength in one another, and that we will grow together side by side. You are my partner in crime, my best friend, and I love you with every beat of my heart.
Mm-hmm. So sweet. Wedding rings are worn as a symbol of commitment between a bride and a groom. They're circular in shape to represent their love, with no beginning and no end. They represent what has been and what will be. And they're made of a strong and sturdy material that's sure to withstand years and years of hand-holding, dishwashing, bargain shopping, fishing, snowboarding, and of course, firefighting. May I ask? Couples wear these rings every day as a symbol and a token of their love towards each other. And who will be presenting the rings today? We got them, right? Oh, yeah. Okay, who's?
Got me nervous.
That's next. That will be Lauren. Yeah, I think so. That's for you, Nick. Okay, Nick, you'll be going first. Okay. If you want to give me that, I'll take the box. Oh, sure. Okay, Nick, please place the ring on the front of Lauren's finger, ring finger, and repeat after me. You ready?
Yep.
Lauren, I love you.
Lauren, I love you.
My heart is in this ring.
My heart is in this ring.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I promise to be your faithful husband.
I promise to be your faithful husband.
To love you when the sun shines.
To love you when the sun shines.
And when the rain falls.
And when the rain falls.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
When you look at this ring, think of me.
When you look at this ring, think of me.
And remember that I will always love you.
And remember that I will always love you.
Lauren, it's your turn. May you place the ring on the front of Nick's finger.
Okay.
And repeat after me. Nick, I love you.
Nick, I love you.
My heart is in this ring.
My heart is in this ring.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I promise to be your faithful wife.
I promise to be your faithful wife.
To love you when the sun shines.
To love you when the sun shines.
And the rain falls.
And the rain falls.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
When you look at this ring, think of me.
When you look at this ring, think of me.
And remember that I will love you always.
And remember that I will love you always.
You may slide the ring onto Nick's finger. Now, it's been a great day and it's been a true honor and privilege, and thank you for giving me this opportunity. But all good things must come to an end. And I'm gonna say something you've been waiting for me to say and hear for a very long time now.
Right.
By the powers vested in me by the great state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Yay! You may kiss the bride. Nice. Birds fly.
high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dream that you did to, oh why can't I, oh, someday I wish upon a star, wake up with the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like a lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you find. Why, oh why can't I?